I used to eat this all the time. So I have my own version. This is the cream. Vamos in here. And I will show you how I do my version. Raising my own children, I come to find out that this bangos is very, very, that was 2 cups of water. Bangos is very, very, a lot, it has a lot of bones, and it's my children's favorite also at the same time. So I am worried about the bones for them. So what I do is gonna show you how I make them. Two cups of water, 1 tablespoon of salt. Well, let's make it 3/4 tablespoon of salt and 1 cup of vinegar. Okay, that's 1 cup of vinegar, and we will put some ginger. It will come out like sardines. Chop it up. So it will be ready. It will color the fish. By the way, we call the fish bangos, but in English they call it milk fish. It's very good. One of this, because maybe half of it for now, just for smell, because you want the aroma of this long hot Italian. Now, that's the way it looks like. We're gonna cover it. We're using the pressure cooker because the bones will become very, very soft. When you do this, it will automatically come off the seeds. These are all washed already. And I like to add some vegetable for my pagsiyo na bangus.
As you can see, I have this bitter melon in there. It's good for diabetic. And I have this round eggplant to balance everything. Because this, you can just get this. From this water, nothing in it. Okay. These are all washed already. I guess that one don't wanna go with it. How beautiful they are when they go inside. When this is already soft, because the pressure cooker make it, when you leave it like at least 30-35 minutes, set it until, just leave it alone until it cools down, and then you open the pressure cooker, be careful, and then add this and then boil it again until this one cooked. Of course, I don't want to keep you waiting until it boils. That's gonna be a lot of minutes. So that's it for now.